Hi guys, and welcome back to Pass the Move. For today's episode, we've got a nice little game for you against Hull. Nothing major, but as I mentioned in the last episode, don't really want to be showing you guys the same games over and over again, you know, the Arsenal, Chelsea, City games over and over again. It sort of gets a bit boring, so we're going to change things up a little bit. Speaking of the last episode, in the last episode, we did play against Real Madrid in the Champions League, and that ended 2-2, so if you didn't watch that, you should definitely check it out. But yeah, as you can see from the list of results here, really mixed bag of results in truth. Played a number of games since the last episode, as I like to play about 7 games per episode, in between per episode basically. But yeah, the game that followed that was a great 8-1 win against Norwich, as you can see here. Just plenty of goals to spare, and they only got the consolation goal in the 86th minute. The game that followed that, though, was a strange 3-0 loss to Aston Villa. It was almost like the scoreline suggests that they definitely dominated us. It's just absolutely weird. I'll show you in a minute what I mean as well. But what followed that was a nice little straightforward win against Feyenoord. We also drew against them quite disappointingly in the Champions League as well. We did qualify for the next round. If I can show you here, our last game is going to be against Real Madrid for the top spot basically, but we are definitely qualified. Whether it's second or first, it really depends if we manage to beat Real Madrid in the next game. And then yeah, after that was the 4-1 win against Newcastle. That was a nice little win. John Joshelvy only managing to score through a penalty, made things a little nervy for us towards the end, but James Wilson managed to grab his first goal of the season there, coming off the bench if I'm not mistaken. What followed that was the City game. It was a nice, it was actually just a decent draw against City, where they definitely dominated. We didn't have a single shot on target. It was quite the strange game. No matter what I did tactically, we just couldn't get out and do anything at all, really. They only had 2 half chances themselves, so it's not like much happened in this game. Quite the boring game, and I guess it makes sense it ended 0-0. But yeah, we did beat Liverpool 3-0, and that was a nice little win there. Yeah, in these fixtures, I experimented with Rashford up top and Martial on the wing, but it actually proved that Martial is just a much better as a striker, and Rashford's just much better as a left winger as an inside forward. So I've switched it back now. I think that experiment's pretty much done and done and dusted, really. And then yeah, again we get beaten by a strange, not a strange team, but a weaker team, a 3-1 loss this time. I thought it was going to be a repeat of a 3-0 loss, but Juan had to manage to get a goal on the brink of half time, which gave us a little bit of hope to go on and score some more goals. It actually didn't end up being that way. Instead, it did just end the 3-1 win to Bournemouth. And in terms of match stats, they pretty much dominated. In truth, they managed to score the 3 goals without a single clear-cut chance. There's 2 here, but that only happened after us, and they in fact missed those chances. But yeah, it was a strange game. They just managed to score 3 goals without a single clear-cut chance. And we also managed to score 1 without a clear-cut chance or even half chance. So it was that kind of game, really. But we did manage to bounce back and beat Basel 3-0. So I'm hoping this win pretty much secured us the qualification for the next round. But I'm hoping this game against Hull will really, we need to step up our performances in the Premier League. And I'll show you exactly what I mean by that. We're 12 games in, and it looks like we're set for another Champions League battle, even though we just fought 5 points away. By no means I'm not writing this off for the title, but we're really going to have to step up recent performances. As I mentioned last season, you can really only afford to lose about 5 or 6 times and draw just about the same number as well. If I show you previous seasons, you'll see exactly what I mean by the winners. So Arsenal only lost 6 and drew 6 last season. We've already managed to lose 3 and draw 3 as well, I think. No, only drew twice. But yeah, even the season before that, Arsenal only lost 4 times, and most of them against top teams. What I'll show you, which is strange this season, is we've actually managed to beat Liverpool, Chelsea and Tottenham. And we drew against City. The derby one was a bit disappointing, but you can understand it. Sometimes when you're away from home, you draw. But the losses are just absolutely strange. We haven't lost to any sort of major team or even a mid-table team for that matter. We've just had some strange losses. A 1-0 loss to Leicester you can write off as a something that doesn't really happen too frequently, but the Bournemouth and Aston Villa losses has just been bizarre, really. I just can't really wrap my head around it, because they were quite heavy losses. considering the margins. It wasn't just like a close game and then they managed to win. They just absolutely dominated us. And I have a feeling it has a little bit to do with the system, the game getting used to the way we play, really. But we managed to get Pogba and De Gea, as well as Mkhitaryan, back from injury. They're only recently come back, so they aren't all completely fit. As you can see, Pogba's still getting his match sharpness back. De Gea has managed his match sharpness, but he's a goalkeeper, so you sort of expect that to come quite quickly to him. So we are going to be playing with, finally, a Verratti and Pogba midfield. I'm hoping to see this partnership really bring out the best of both of them. Verratti, obviously we have to allow him a season to adapt, but so far not too bad. His average rating overall has been a 7.11 overall rating. It's been the Premier Division where he's struggled a little bit. I mean, not too much, it's just 6.97, so it's not bad by any means. But he's where he's really, you know, shown up has been in the European Champions League, basically. I'm excited about that partnership, and we'll be playing with Lingard, Januzaj and Rashford. This is really a very young front four of players. I think Lingard is the oldest at 25 years of age, Januzaj is 23, Rashford is 21, and Anthony Martial is about 22. Lutrell misses out due to injury. Stand back for Smalling and Jones, they're my first choice now, they're just playing great together. Mario Fernandez, as always, has just been wonderful. He's managed to score a goal this season, as well as provide 5 assists. Just top player, really. I'm just so glad I got him in. And Herrera and Depay will miss out. But let's just get into today's game. We've been talking quite a while. Let's just see whether my players can walk the walk and not just talk the talk. We do definitely need the win against Hull today. We are, of course, the favourites. I think a win would send us 2 points closer to Chelsea, and that only depends on whether they actually lose their game or not. I don't think they play today. I think they'll be playing later on. Arsenal have already played their game. We can close the gap between us and them to just 1 point as well. So Arsenal actually had some strange losses as well. They've lost against Stoke, Wolves, Tottenham and Chelsea. And early on in the season, they're quite far down, but they managed to climb up the table now. And due to our strange performances, they've managed to go ahead of us. Hull playing with a quite defensive system here, as you can see. 3 in the back, 2 wingers. I'm expecting my team to exploit the flanks and, you know, really take advantage of that one wide man that they're playing on either side, on either flank. We're going to get a nice little 3D intro here with the players coming out of the tunnel. For some reason, they're playing with an injured player. I'm going to let the players, you know, play around. It's actually one of their strikers. Who's that? Fernandes. Okay, so that's good. He's quite a key player for them. I'm going to let my players deal with the game as it is for now. I don't think I'll change anything yet. Oh, Popo, that was a beautiful ball that he played. Marshall's going to get a nice early chance here. His goalkeeper does well there, but he should have really placed it a little bit better. But I'll take that. I'll let my players, you know, start the game. Oh, okay. Wow, we got a penalty within 45 minutes. That's incredible. Foul on Pogba, apparently. And it will be Verratti, by the looks of it, who's going to get the chance to score his first Premier League goal. I think he's already managed to score in the Champions League, but this will be his chance to score his first Premier League goal. And can he do it? Yes, he can. No mistake. Goalkeeper goes the wrong way. And that's a nice little early start. That's just going to encourage my players a little bit more. But I expect Hull to bounce back and try. You know, we've been struggling against the smaller teams a couple of times now, so that's the worry, that they might come back and score some more. But yeah, I'm going to let my players, you know, deal with the situation as is. I thought he was going to get a chance, but instead he spreads it out wide to Mario Fernandes, who plays it back into Marshall. Apparently that's another penalty. No mistake, what's going on? I was just going to say, I'll let my players take advantage of the wide men themselves before I actually instruct them to look for the overlap. But, you know, Verratti's going to have a chance to grab a brace from his deep-line playmaker role, so that's a bit strange. And this time Martial does guess the right way, and that's a poor penalty by Verratti. Considering we have Anthony Martial as well as Pogba in the team, it's a bit strange for him to be taking the penalties, but we're still 1-0 up, so I can't complain too much. We are dominating absolutely. Hull only recently had their first shot right now, and they didn't even get that on target. We are going to bring the ball forward here through Januzaj. Manages to find Pogba. For some reason, Januzaj is sticking next to him. We need someone in this hole here. I don't know why they're there. Rashford takes a long shot, as absolutely not going to go in by any means. We're coming onto the half an hour mark, and we're going to get a chance to a set piece here. Pogba puts a decent ball into the box, but it's cleared. He's going to get another chance to put something decent in, but instead he loses the ball out to Livermore. It's actually Hull who are going to come with the counter attack, even though they don't seem too keen. And Borthwick Jackson reads that well, and Pogba's going to get a third chance to do something here. He lays it off to Yanazai, who finds Borthwick Jackson, who puts a decent cross in, but goalkeeper deals with it, no one really attacking it. And this highlight is still going on. Lingard's going to get a chance to do something special here. Can he put a nice early little box in? Ball in, I was going to say. Not a box. Ball into the box. But he does do that. But Rashford misses from a really short range. And that is the third clear-cut chance of the game. Two of those being penalties. But yeah, this is just... we're dominating right now. And Lingard puts a nice ball again across. And Rashford this time makes no mistake to tuck that in. And that will be 2-0. Within half an hour, and looks like we'll be cruising this game a little bit. And yeah, I'm just a little glad to be showing you guys a game in which we appear to be winning in. And that is the third penalty. Honestly, what are Hull doing here? I don't think I've ever gotten three penalties in a row. And I think this time it won't be Verratti to take it. It might be someone else. It's going to be Rashford. It looks like he's been kicked off penalty duties, apparently. I don't actually have anyone set on penalties. I probably should, but I trust my players. And more often than not, they score it. And Rashford makes no mistake to score that one. And that is 3-0 to us. And we're cruising just before halftime. I'm glad we're putting this game to bed early. We can, you know, use that time to give a couple of our players a bit of rest, considering that we will be playing. And wow, that was cleared off the line by one of the players on the near post, I think that was. But yeah, we just rest our players before the Real Madrid game. We need to give our players, well, some rest, basically. But yeah, you know, a crucial win would send us top of the group, and that's exactly what we're going to do. It's our first time back into the... What a free kick from Pogba. It'll be our first time back in the Champions League since Sir Alex... No. I think David Moyes was in the Champions League as well. Yeah, he was in his first season, but he didn't actually qualify it for himself. So this is the first time United will be qualifying through a manager that wasn't Sir Alex Ferguson. And, you know, we've done quite decently in our group. We've done quite well. And... we have reason to be optimistic, basically. The Madrid draw was a bit disappointing, considering we had five clear-cut chances. But, you know, to draw with a team like Madrid is quite good, considering my United team are nowhere near them in terms of quality just yet. And my team needs plenty of experience. So we're going to take off Verratti because he's a little bit tired. Give Yanazai a bit of a break as well. And we'll let Rashford get his hat-trick, hopefully. But I think Mario Fernandez, just because he's on a yellow, and we can give him a little bit of a rest as well. But yeah, in terms of quality and experience, I don't think we're there with Madrid just yet. I mean, they do have Ronaldo, Bale still, as well as Morata's probably got great ability now, I'm assuming, just because considering his potential. And we've got only Pogba, De Gea, and I'm not even sure if Verratti can be considered world class, but if he's not, then he's at least you know, a star Premier League player. So yeah, we don't have like crazy good players, and the truth of the matter is I used to get rid of anyone that was only considered to be a good Premier Division side player in terms of ability. Obviously, if they had potential, I'll just let them carry on until their potential is fulfilled, or if it's not, then of it, that's a decent goal from Hull, really, but we shouldn't be conceding that at all. My players just switched off. But yeah, you still only keep anyone who's leading player for Premier League sides or above in terms of ability. And I always used to sell players who are just good ability. And I'm not really a fan of that now. I prefer to keep my players as much as possible. I like when they retire at the club after you've given years of service, basically, just to let them retire at the club. That's what they deserve. And I guess that might be a bit of a weakness of mine, but I prefer keeping players who are useful to the team. If they fit into the side, if they're playing well, there's no need to just sell them just because you want someone who's a higher ability. They may not necessarily bring you the same performances that you expect just because they're better players in terms of ability. And I prefer getting, you know, youth products and players bringing in through the club. That's my sort of thing, really traditional Manchester United sort of philosophy. and it's what I go for. I try to hold on to my players as much as possible. Unless one of them asks to leave and is complaining about the game time, then I'll definitely just sell them. I don't really put up with that sort of thing. But yeah, that's what I'm going for, and I'm hoping in this third season it would pay off. We have had a gradual progression from fifth place to second place last season, and we weren't too far off from Arsenal. And I'm hoping to see more progression this season, whether we win a trophy or whether we go quite far in the Champions League, or whether we even win the Premier Division. I'd really hope that we could win the Premier Division. I thought we would do it this season, but you know, my team has showed me that their low levels of aggression and leadership has come at quite a cost, as well as their age, really. Let me show you the age of my players here. So we've only got two players in their 30s, and one of them's Romero, who barely plays. This only matters, he's the oldest player in the squad now. A number of these players are in their peak now as well. But they're not all first teamers. So as you can see, Mkhitaryan, Mata, Smalling, and Fernandes, as well as De Gea, are the ones that are in their peaks, and they're the ones that start most games because they're first choice players. If we quickly have a look at the average age of the squad, if we can find that. Our average age of the squad is 25 years old only, and you know, the average for the Premier Division is actually 27, so quite a young squad. I expect it to not backfire, but rather that, you know, we'll eventually get some more experience. It's really our front four who are the most youngest in the team. You know, we're relying on Rashford and Martial, who both got 20 plus goals last season, if I can show that somehow. Says he's only gotten 15 in the Premier League, but he actually managed to get 21 overall. And Rashford as well. So these players are young, but they're still doing, you know, quite the job. I don't want to bring in players who are ready-made when that would just, you know, ruin their progress. And as you can see here, 25 goals overall for Marcus Rashford. He was a top goal scorer last season, if I'm not mistaken. And, you know, we have the money. The board invested another 70 million for us, so we've gone from 40 million to 100 million as well. So we can bring in players without a doubt. And you know, I only see it when it's necessary. So far, I don't see it being necessary to sell anyone just yet. We're performing decently. We could certainly do with improvements in terms of ability, but players are doing the job, so why not? But yeah, I think that'll be all for today's episode. So if you enjoyed it, then please hit the like button as well, subscribe. And in terms of when we'll be back, normally I do seven Premier League games. So I'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I might do the Arsenal game, but as I mentioned earlier, I'm not really a fan of showing you guys consistently the same games. I feel like it's been two seasons now, plenty of episodes of you guys seeing the same games over and over, where it's been Arsenal, City, Chelsea, Tottenham, and over again. And that gets quite boring, so I'm a fan of playing games such as the one here today against Hull. Yes, they were a smaller team, but it was really important for us to win the game, because if we didn't, Watford would have gone above us. A couple of teams could have gone above us, and we managed to close the gap a little bit more now. So it's been, we're 2 points away from the top. Chelsea's yet to play their game, but they will be playing Burnley tomorrow, who are in the relegation side, so they might actually, you know, draw that game possibly. Because Burnley would be fighting to get out of the relegation zone. They're quite far down. Then again, they could obviously, Chelsea, just dominate them. But either way, we've closed the gap to at least second spot. You know, we're only one spot away from Arsenal and Tottenham, 1 point away. So that's helpful. This is still a big win, even if it wasn't being played against a big team. So I think we will be back for the Leicester game. It'll be a nice little fun game to play. In terms of where Leicester ended last season, I actually have no clue. We'll have a quick look here. And they didn't do too bad. Ninth spot. That's not bad at all, 59 points, 10 away from, you know, the Europa League spot here. But yeah, I think we'll be back for the Leicester game. That'll be a nice little bit of fun here. We do need to get our revenge, because they beat us at our home, so that's quite, you know, embarrassing. We need to beat them at their stadium, and that's exactly what we'll be aiming to do. If we progress further in the Champions League group or in the FA Cup, if we go really far, just like in the previous episode, if we make it all the way to the final, definitely show you guys that final without a doubt. But yeah, I think that'll be all for today. So I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you liked it, hit the like button as well, subscribe, and thank you guys for watching.